Hello, hi my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR by Info. In this class, I am going to continue the digestion of proteins. In the previous class, we have discussed the fundamental aspects of the proteins. So, let us start. Digestion of proteins. Digestion of proteins, especially in today's class, I am going to give explanation about the how digestion of proteins takes place in the elementary canal of human digestive system. See, the digestion, it includes the mouth, stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. Small intestine and large intestine. In these parts, in the mouth, there is no digestion of the proteins. The digestion actually started or initiated in the stomach, and also the digestion takes place in the small intestine. Whereas there is no digestion in the large intestine. So let us see how digestion of stomach, how the digestion of proteins that takes place in the stomach and in the small intestine. In the mouth, there is no digestion of the proteins because of the lack of any proteases. Lack of any proteases that leads to the there is no digestion of the proteins in the mouth. Okay, clear. So let us come to the stomach. Stomach is a site where actually digestion of proteins initiated. Stomach that produces two enzymes. Enzyme one is a pepsin. Enzyme 2 is a renin. Pepsin and renin. Small intestine also produces some enzymes, and also small intestine, especially in the small intestine, in the duodenum and also rest of small intestine. These are the two places of small intestine. Here some enzymes are produced, some enzymes are mixed in the duodenum, and rest of the small intestine produces some of the enzymes which are essential for the digestion of the proteins. Let us see. Duodenum is a place where pancreatic juices are mixed. Pancreatic juices are mixed with the what? Food. Rest of the thing, that is a small intestine, that produces the some enzymes, especially two types of enzymes. They include the aminopeptidases and also dipeptidases. Here, pancreatic juices that contain the enzymes which are act on the proteins. These pancreatic juices especially contain the trypsin, chymotrypsin, elastase and carboxypeptidase. Okay, these are the enzymes. You can see what are the enzymes here. Pepsin is the enzyme which is essential for the digestion of protein. Renin and trypsin, chymotrypsin, elastase, carboxypeptidase, and also aminopeptidases, dipeptidases. Aminopeptidase and dipeptidase. See, let us start with the enzyme that is the pepsin. Pepsin. You know, pepsin is secreted by the stomach. Pepsin is secreted by the stomach. It is a endopeptidase. Endopeptidase. I already mentioned the what are the endopeptidases in the previous classes. And it is produced by the stomach as a zymogen. Produced by the stomach as a zymogen. This zymogen nothing but the pepsinogen. Pepsinogen. This pepsinogen get converted into the pepsin active form. Active form by the action of the hydrochloric acid which is secreted by the inner layer of the stomach. Now, this pepsin that act on the proteins nothing but the polypeptides, and these proteins get converted into the polypeptides plus peptides. Peptides mean it may di, tri, tetra. Di, tri and tetra. Pepsin is an enzyme which activates the another enzyme that is a renin. That is a renin. Here one point to be noted, the initially activated pepsin again that act on the pepsinogen. Again that act on the pepsinogen, that is called as a autocatalysis. Autocatalysis. And which produce again the pepsin. In this way, excess amount of the pepsin is produced in the stomach. The stomach that contains the excess amount of pepsin that act on the proteins produces the polypeptides and the peptides, and also that act on the renin. Actually, renin also enzyme especially present in the children's. Especially present in the children's. This renin is a renin produced as a zymogen that is called as a pro-renin. Pro-renin. This pro-renin get converted into the renin by the enzyme pepsin. I already mentioned here. By the enzyme pepsin. Then see function of renin. Function of renin in the children. The renin actually that act on the milk of infants. Infants are children that takes the milk of the milk is the energy source. That milk contains the a protein that is called as a casein. This casein get converted into the para caseinate by the enzyme renin. By the enzyme renin. Again, this para caseinate combined with the calcium, which produces the calcium para caseinate. Calcium para caseinate. This calcium para caseinate is digested by the an enzyme that is called as pepsin. The calcium para caseinate is also called as a curdling of milk. Curdling of milk. It means regularly we are using curd, such type of material we here call as a curdling of milk. So pepsin, actually what is the function of pepsin? Pepsin that act on the proteins, they produces the polypeptides and peptides. polypeptides and
peptides.
In this way, the stomachs are producing pepsin and renin enzymes. The pepsin and renin enzyme that converts proteins which are present in the food into the polypeptides and also
peptides.
So, let us see the duodenum. Duodenum that contains the food acts, actually it is called as an acid can. This acid can is mixed with the pancreatic juices. Actually these pancreatic juices that contain the enzymes trypsin. Okay, here I want to mention one more point for the pepsin. Pepsin, especially that act on the specialized area in the polypeptide or protein that act at the site of amino acids, in between amino acids, such amino acids include the aromatic amino acids, especially tyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine, and leucine. Here you can see if there is a polypeptide, whenever the tyrosine tryptophan, for example this is a tyrosine, why? Tryptophan, W, phenylalanine, F. This is the enzyme that is especially pepsin that act here and here, that cannot act on here. This should be noted. So, trypsin, let us come to the trypsin. Trypsin also endopeptidase, which is secreted by the pancreas, and this endopeptidase especially act at the specialized areas that is called as a basic amino acids. Basic amino acids like arginine and lysine. These are the basic amino acids. If wherever the protein that contains these two amino acids, for example, here is the arginine, here is the lysine, then only they act on here. Wherever the two amino acids adjacent, that is the arginine and lysine, there only this trypsin is acting. Trypsin act. And this trypsin convert the protein into the peptides plus polypeptides. The next enzyme is chymotrypsin. Chymotrypsin also endopeptidase. These endopeptidase especially act on the specialized amino acids. In between the specialized amino acids, they include the aromatic amino acids. As like pepsin, aromatic amino acids are the targets for the chymotrypsin. What are the aromatic amino acids? Simply see tyrosine, tryptophan and phenylalanine. These chymotrypsin also play another important role that is called as the curdling of milk in adults. This is a property which is very similar to the renin of children's, renin of infants. So, in the curdling, what it converts paracaseinate into the calcium paracaseinate. Again, this calcium paracaseinate is digested by the enzyme pepsin. Okay, paracaseinate converted into the calcium paracaseinate. This is digested by the pepsin in the adult. This pepsin produces the polymer of proteins. Polyproteins are peptides. So, this is the functions of the chymotrypsin. Here, we have to remember is the renin function in adult. That is a very important. The action of chymotrypsin in these amino acids as well as the pepsin. These two points are very essential and very important to competitive exam. Okay. Next enzyme is elastase. Elastase also peptidase. It acts on the proteins and polypeptides. Proteins and polypeptides. Especially, this elastase has a specialized character. That is, this elastase is only act wherever the simple amino acids are present. Like glycine, alanine, serine. Wherever the glycine, alanine, serine is there elastase is and produces the peptides. Coming to the one more enzyme, that is the carboxypeptidase. Carboxypeptidase is an enzyme. This enzyme acts at the site of carboxy group. COOH. At the site of carboxy group of protein. I already mentioned in the morning NH2. For example, this is a polypeptide that ends contain the COOH. See here, carboxypeptidase is an enzyme that act at the COOH region. COOH region, it releases this amino acid. Again, there is this type of structure. Again, it acts here and it releases this. In this way, they releases the single amino acids by acting at the site of the COOH group of polypeptide. So, in this way, carboxypeptidase is acted. So, the next enzyme is a small intestine produced enzyme, that is a aminopeptidase. Aminopeptidase is an enzyme that acts at the site of amine group. of polypeptide. For example, this is a polypeptide. This polypeptide that contains the amine group here, carboxylic group here. So, aminopeptidase act here. It releases this amino acid. And next to the step, in the next step, it produces the, it releases this one. Because here is the amine group. So, in this way, this is the enzyme that breaks all the peptide bonds which is very near to the amine group. So, finally what it producing? This is the pre-amino acids. Pre-amino acids in the small intestine. The next enzyme is the dipeptidase. By the action of previous all the enzymes that produces the peptides, these peptides contain the dipeptides. These dipeptides means there is only two amino acids. These two amino acids get separated individual amino acid by the enzyme dipeptidase. In this way, complete conversion of the protein into the single amino acids or pre-amino acids. These pre-amino acids are the ready for absorption by the microvilli of small intestine. These three amino acids are ready to absorb by the small intestine microvilli. In this way, conversion of polypeptide containing proteins into the pre-amino acids by the various peptidases which are started from the stomach to the ends at the small intestine. So, in this way, whatever the food we are taking that contains the protein, that proteins get digested by the different kinds of enzymes which are involved in the human digestive system. If you like this video, please do subscribe my channel, like, share and comment. Thank you.